Parang na-open mo na nga yung pagdating dun sa condition ni Santino na nandoon siya sa autism spectrum, di ba? Dahil dito, paano sa tingin mo na nabago nito yung isang Martin Rivera, yung buhay mo?
Nagbago talaga yung buhay ko. Everything that I live for, everything that I breathe, everything that I do in life, it's talagang nothing compared to the challenges that Santino will be going through forever. Sa lahat ng mga bata na sa spectrum, it's going to be a challenge talaga. And being the father that I am, which is never around, that kind of father, mahirap to instill into Santino, to teach him what I think the world should look like. Because they have, may illusion na sila. I think they know what the world looks like through their eyes. Sana we can see the world through the eyes of an autistic child, because there's magic there. Mm-hmm. There's hope there. We all need to self-improve, di ba? Mm-hmm. But to be judged throughout your life has been my biggest fear. If he can go through life as a child, as a human being, as a man, will he ever be able to say and admit to the world that he has something that other kids don't have? That's always been my biggest fear. So I've become an interpreter. I've become, you know, that the art of showbiz is to entertain. And now I've learned how to entertain, because I'm literally every second of my life entertaining Santino so that he doesn't see the world as ugly or as the things that people say, the words that go by, and maybe he didn't hear it, the looks that people give because he's flapping in public or he's having a fit, or when he was younger, when he used to throw things off the table. I'm the concert king. It's not supposed to happen to me. If this can happen to me, this can happen to anyone. And it's not happening to me. It's happening to my son. And all I can do, all we can do, is pick up the mess. Never mind what people think. This is a lifelong, forever condition. So we have to learn to live with it and not apologize for it. And that's what I've learned. I've stopped apologizing. Oh, I'm so sorry. He's. You don't do that. I'm sorry, he's special. No, your child is special. Your child is special. Everyone's child is special. Stop making, that's what I learned. Mm. Stop making apologies. There's nothing to be sorry for. And stop blaming yourself for the situation that he's in. Just be there. Be present. Even when you're not physically there, he needs to know that I'm there. Mm. That's why every time I see him every other month, every other 2 months, there seems to be a bond between Santino and I. Maybe I was also on the spectrum when I was younger, because I understand him. I know what he's trying to say. Mas magaling ako dyan. Mahirapan ako sa Tagalog, di ba? But in the spectrum world of autism, I seem to understand. And it's funny, because even as a kid growing up, even as early as when I started the show business, kids, special kids, always somehow gravitate toward me. And I don't know why. Now I know why. Because I have one. I have a special child. And I'm so proud. So proud and so scared at the same time. Because I'm not going to be here forever. And when he is already on his own, who's gonna translate? Who's gonna tell people, not apologize, but not tell people, ang ibig niya sabihin na gutom siya, sorry, medyo in love siya sa mga mermaid. Why does my son, 16-year-old boy, 6 foot, why does he like mermaids? What is it about mermaids? Don't make fun of him. Jump in the water. Look for the mermaid. They exist. There's magic in the world. And we don't know how to handle it until it happens to you. Yeah. It's happening to me, and I love it. I love this challenge. I wish I was a better father to all three boys, but I'm not. But it is what it is. I do the best I can. I'm still here to entertain everybody. But my real life is a challenge. And that's why I'm always in the States, so I can co-parent this special child. Robin and Ram, they're helping me now because they're close to Santino. So this could be a God thing that they're all together in the same country, that they can take over. Is God trying to tell me, that's it, you got your 40 years, maybe you have to start thinking about what happens after. Maybe that's what this day is all about. And it's scary. It's really scary.